working really hard. So I don't know what you guys are running.
Leave that one.
I'm running about 18 or 20, so.
Thank you.
I could hardly see. Fuck, yeah, the dust is bad.
Yeah, I had to back off a little bit.
Yep.
Too much dust, couldn't see the whoops.
Yeah, there's a couple of deep hollows there. If you don't, you can't see it.
Yeah, lucky you cleared and I saw it. Gave me enough time to stand.
Yeah.
Any more up further like that? Keep an eye on.
He said something about wombat holes later on or something.
Yeah, that's up further. We've got to cross over to the other side of the track. It's a lot smoother, but there are like sinkholes.
Whoever's out front, I reckon they should just let everyone know. A lot of us don't know the track. I don't know the track.
No, me either. It's the first time I've been on it.
Yeah, whoever's up front.
Yeah. Once we're on that flat bit, you could ride side by side, but it's fucking dangerous with the rabbit one. The wombat holes.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Because they come up quick. Again, it depends on how fast you want to ride.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, back's doing alright actually. It's here, not fit.
Yeah, the hips, yeah.
Unbike fit. Just doing this shit.
We're not going to get.
Well, you want to sit here for half an hour while I set up the drone and follow you, and then you got to wait for me for half an hour to pack it away. And
oh, okay.
Yeah, we're not going to get the pin away.
So I don't want to wait the whole time. Got to take some vision.
So
you know, we'll swap with people at the front, yeah, so I can get pictures of everybody.
Unless you
hopefully
go
crash
in the front.
It. No.
Yeah, don't I just want that.
Take my fancy. I'll just yeah, we go.
I've got the first code and everything here, but
Nah,
we don't need that.
No. Yeah,
but I'm
going to
get the scrap out of my bag.
Okay. Next stop.
Yeah.
Next stop, we'll Reg, at the next stop, you'll swap the camera in.
Yeah. No worries. Smoko, next time we stop.
What?
Just so I can play.
Do what?
Just have a quick Smoko, next stop.
Yeah. Fuck it up, actually.
Thank you.
How long does this road follow the track for?
That road.
All the way.
Oh, cool. So if I did set up my drone, get everyone to ride in a bit of a pack, I'll get some footage. I'll land the drone, pack her up, and then I'll just follow the road until I catch up again. Is that alright? Thank you.
that's the second year. That's the second year. KTM, Yamaha, Honda, and AJP. She's great. And a lot of the guys now really having some serious problems with them.
One
with the triples, one guy in the States snapped it, shot it out of the
swing or the knuckles.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
I had it for about 4 months. Obviously, I didn't have it that long to really ride it, but what I got to know about it after I've done it all up, my last name's good enough, but I used another's maiden name after that.
And you sold that to Michael?
Yep, that's the one. Yep. Obviously.
That's 1 point. No, they're not Thank you.
beautiful.
Mate,
wasn't it?
That was lovely.
Nice fast track.
Yeah.
Oh, I was sitting on the 110 in spots.
Yeah, no, exactly right. How'd you go to gas, mate?
Oh, I hung back a bit, but then that last part there.
Yeah,
it doubled
off a bit.
Yeah, a couple of nice little tight bits in there too. Ooh,
you
yeah, to pick your line.
If I stick close enough to your tail, I'll be able to see over your shoulder when I'm going.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. But, oh, hell. Nah, that was fantastic.
Like, yeah, I'd love that.
I mean, this track.
I'd be quite comfortably through there.
Yeah, no, this is excellent.
This is easier than the Bloody Murray Bridge Tarlum track.
Yeah.
I reckon the track that I do, I reckon that'd be more like the Palmer track.
Yep.
Be a bit more similar to that.
Yeah.
The Palmer one's a bit more sandier though, where the tail and the bridge is more train jibbers and shit and this stuff.
Yeah, I still haven't done that.
It's not bad. There's a couple of bad spots. There's one bad spot to really kick the arse into the bike up as you come up under a low lying tree on the ridge.
Yep.
That'll really kick your ass up. You've got to keep to the left on that one. Right at the start, as you go past the first stoby pole to go into a gully, there's a big washout on the left track, stick to your right. Otherwise, you're going that, you're going to be a bit interesting.
Oh, no, exactly right. I mean,
apart from that, it's a pretty good track.
Yeah.
There's one spot's a bit of dead sand. As you come out, you'll end up, there's a cement culvert thing, sticks up. Then there's a really tight left turn in towards the fence line. It's a very tight turn, like a first gear turn.
See people coming pretty hot?
Yes, you go through, you just head into the bushes. Yeah. You come out, and when you come along the train line, the fence line, you come back towards the train line, it's really dead sand, just in that spot, it'll grab
just
your
drops
front.
Drops out, end. Yeah. Nice.
And then the rest is okay.
Oh, you wouldn't go riding if it was going to be easy, would you?
That's it. You got to build these up.
Exactly right.
Lead. Loving it. That was heavy. One, two, three. Heavy bitch.
Yeah, I got the side stand in there too, bro.
It's a Sunday, mate. No expectations on a Sunday.
That's it. Overbalanced it.
You're getting too complacent.
Up.
Bloody overrunning him.
Oh, hell. Because I wasn't getting target fixation on you, but I was that close to you that wherever you went, that sort of shut the door on me. Yeah. Oh, it was fantastic, but...
Yeah, I come in a bit hot in a couple of corners there. But bloody...
I mean, even though there's not a whole lot of run-up, there is run-up. So
yeah.
Are you all going for horizontal at the moment?
That one should be.
Oh, bugger it. Okay, that one a hell of a shame for quite a while.
Oh, okay.
I sort of like going right behind you and weaving around and whatnot.
Not sure how to...
Nah, it's alright.
I haven't used this one before, so I'm not too sure.
Same sort of functions. Yeah, oh, hell. There are a couple of points up here that starts to get a little bit hairy. But it's not for a while still, so it should be fine, but
yeah.
Oh hell. No, I was all over the rear end like a bloody wet rag, it's bloody fantastic, but
I think that's recording now.
Too much fucking electronic shit.
Fucking
when you're playing around with power commanders.
It's one thing leads to another before you know
it. It's so hard to keep up with everything.
Yeah, and well, when you're on a bike like that, that's a help. You're throwing up good sized stones.
Is it?
Yeah,
sorry if I
No, don't worry about that. No, I don't like doing that.
No,
don't worry about that, man. No,
no
worries at all. I mean, I knew what I was getting myself in. Yeah, well, I was going to say, there was a couple of big stones went whizzing past my chest. So, oh, yeah. So, no, I was always like staggered way off. Oh, so, I was like, that was neat.
On the nice flat places, I like that, didn't I?
Oh yeah, bloody oath. Yeah, well when you're pushing that much horsepower, yeah, of course you do. Yeah. Nah, it's great fun. Bloody excellent little track.
It is. It's a really nice track.
Can you your piece down?
How many revs is
your stream? I've no idea. You don't have one of those.
I'm like, can't come down 7 or 8 and fuck the other time. Keep up with you guys.
Oh, it's really to keep up, dude.
Yeah.
Don't go and
play the bike space, dude. Yeah. Cool the motor.
Yeah. And, I don't know, we were sitting on a fair dollar a fair.
$87k in the nice spot.
Yeah.
And on the anchors in the tights.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Where I've overshot.
There's a couple of tight ones.
We're
going to play on straight on through and whatnot.
Lucky's no spot.
Actually, there used to be a couple of people who'd chuck some big railway sleepers going across the track. But it was over through, down near towards Lamaroo a bit further, through some tighter stuff with some really bigger. And they put them right in the base, so you go over with a bit of speed.
You put them out in one of the big tree on the right.
Yeah, the tight
and
little, yeah.
There's a log on
there. You plowed straight through, but because you were on the right hand lane, I was on the left, and we both crossed over. Well, fuck, we were close. But I knew you were going to go straight on, but I thought you were going to go a little bit faster. I thought, oh, yeah, I'll carry a bit of speed into this and stick the boot into it as I go. And fuck, it must have only been about a metre or two.
But, can you see that when I'm flashing that?
There's no worries.
Just when I'm just letting you know.
Yeah.
Decent seat put on it.
Is that Concepts or is that?
No, that's Saddleman.
Oh, Saddleman. Yeah. I think I heard of those guys.
And they have the cutout so there's no impact on the spine.
Yep.
And the tailbone.
The one thing I don't like about those, one thing I don't like about dumpers and adventure bikes, how you seem so upright when those bikes are subjected to the most punishment.
The ergonomics, seat Concepts, I had that on the 690 and I saw it, didn't like it.
Yep.
I've ended up putting a kit 690 on it, and that's got their own seat, it's a custom seat. And
excellent. So I've seen a few people run on those tyres. You're pretty happy with it?
Yeah, the Dunlop on this, yeah. On the other bikes, I've got the Motors Tractionator Deserts.
The Desert HT one? Yeah, that's what I run on my...
The 1290's got the 150.
Fuck, that thing hooks up, but by hell, it's got some grip, that thing. bloody good tyres.
So really I'm pretty happy with the Dunlop on this. I've had a good run. Yep. The Chin Chin, well, that's the last in existence. I've got one on this and one on the 12.9 and that's it.
Yep.
I'm begging to Motos to make one.
Similar?
Yeah.
Yep.
Because they are really awesome and sand.
I really like the Desert HT front end as well.
It's these are wider because...
Actually, yeah. Is that a 110?
It's a 325 by 350 by 21. It's a C755.
Oh, yep.
Hard terrain.
Yep. That's fantastic.
Well, someone just stopped up. Excellent scene. Don't need to let the air out.
Someone stopped up there. They can't see us. I was just go stand out the back.
You don't need to let air out the front end of it.
Yep.
Nothing.
That's like an inch
because of the width.
Yep.
On the 690, I got the 300 by 21.
Oh, just stand out on the railway track. I'll see you.
I got the 321 Motos on the 690, but it's like this all the time.
Yep.
Fighting in the sand. It's shocking.
I was going to say, that one's catching.
Rubbed.
Yeah.
Just rubbed. That's actually, fantastic. I bottomed her out.
Serious? You almost grab it?
Yep. On one of them, I heard a rub.
Oh, you said heard something rub?
Yeah. She hit. It's over there or it was on here.
Oh, yep. Oh, yeah, something touched there.
Yeah, that's
old. No, sorry, that's the brand.
That's old school there. Yep. Bit of a rub. But yeah, somewhere it rubbed, I heard it.
Lovely.
She went, that was in that real roughy
bit there. No, that right after where we stopped. We come out of that. We went in pretty hot into those things.
Yes.
I was watching your head go, jumping up and down. Like, it might slow down through this.
There's a gully in there too.
A couple of the tight ones. Yeah. A
little deep little gully thing in there.
Oh, it's hell. You can bloody kick you in the guts at some of those. Because there's no warning. It'd be a fantastic bit of track. And then all of a sudden, like into a little dog leg or something other, or into a big old dip. But
I'm getting a couple of little hiccups, feeling hiccups. I don't know what's going on.
Just coughing and farting or?
Yeah, for some reason.
I had that on my Dakar a while ago and I couldn't trace it.
Never had
that. I did the entire fuel system from front to rear, replacing. Turned out to be a throttle position sensor.
Yeah,
yep.
I had the same and it was the electrical connection from the fuel pump was cutting in and out.
This is all vacuum.
Yeah, okay.
I've got rid of all that shit. I reckon it might be the just the carbies, FCR's not keeping up.
Yep.
The fuel.
Yeah,
some of the guys in the States, they run regulators for theirs.
Yeah, I was going to say, either not so much a catch can, but like a baffle system or something other as well.
Yeah, they run a regulator to keep the fuel up to the pumps on the SCRs.
No, not a bad idea.
Had them all rebuilt just about a month ago, a bit over.
That's one thing about motorbikes. Anything can go wrong at any moment, and you don't know what it is.
Oh, it's not worrying me, it's nothing serious. No, just having a bit of a little hiccup. I'm not going to throw up.
A bit of track, loving it. How'd you go, mate? That's the way.
Plenty coolant just this morning. Must have overfilled the coolant. She was pissing a bit out.
Not a bad thing.
Just keeping an eye on it.
I was just
under
rig. I would have done the same if I didn't.
Loving it. I'm ready to go back to the Simpson.
I've got a guy, I haven't even done that yet.
Oh, I did it. Oh, it's on the XR.
400 or 650?
630.
Oh, 30, nice.
600.
There was a JE big ball.
Yep.
Excellent.
How do you rip
that? That would have been a hell of a trip.
That was good. I sort of cheated because I went the old man's full drive club.
Oh, you're so supportive. Yep. Good man, that's a good idea. Was that your first trip?
Yeah.
Not a bad idea to go support it on the first trip, that's for sure.
No, I played Scout on that.
Yep.
UHF.
Yeah. Yeah, I was about to ask you about that, because I want to do that sort of stuff, but I don't know where to go in terms of UHF setups.
Garmin Rhino.
Yep.
The latest Garmin Rhino, this is the second latest. I've got the newer one, but they don't make a ram protocol for it, right? So it's either in a pocket or whatever. But that's the second latest one.
Okay.
And these you can't get anymore.
Throat mics?
Yeah, the Vanquish ones, they were the best, but you can get other ones.
Yep.
And try and get the ones that have got the earbud ones.
Yeah, to go in, to go inside. Because I've only got one of those little center, and
PT,
some HR10s. And
PT here.
Yep.
It's good. And then I've got this, and I've got a little sock thing I bought. Slips over the aerial.
Yep.
And screw it on the end of here.
Oh, run your extra.
And gives you the external for a little bit extra distance.
Nice.
emergency or whatever.
Don't rip them, mate. That'd be fantastic.
Yeah, all I've done is I've got a little Android phone on my Daco and I just run a couple of apps and that sort of stuff.
Yeah, I've got the same on mine.
I always run by myself though. So,
same here, this is the first group ride I've done for nearly 20 odd years.
Yep.
Because all my mates
sold
their bikes, got married, shift on, all that.
Yeah, that's the thing, as we're all getting older, I mean, everyone's got different work commitments and whatnot. Yep. And not a bad thing, I suppose, but still.
Yeah, I'm glad to catch up with all you guys, so there's some rides with
me. Yeah, well, this is my first group ride with these guys, so. Those guys down there. Gotta ride to the environment, not yourself sometimes.
I wish I bought two of these bikes.
Well, they're only going up in value, aren't they?
Yeah. Yes. That's so good. Not like the old 640 venture, the old paint shakers. I had one of those a few years back and I ended up putting a 525 rear end, all the subframe and plastics here and give it that bit more of a modern style look. That's up in cool mode.
Yeah, that's it. Wasn't too bad then.
I got some red.
Had a bit of a gap. Well, before I was sitting right behind you because you want to get away from the dust. Okay, really softly, you know, you cross over. Well, you guys had to cross over, you went straight through.
So who overshot those real tight turns?
Overshot
both. Thank God for that big lump of dirt there where you go up on the mound where it's got the ledge.
Yeah.
I'll use that as a boom to get me back on the track.
Did someone overshoot a road as well going into a bush?
We weren't expecting you to own up.
We shot a few spots.
I wish I had a GoPro on me to watch you go doing it all.
I was hoping you got some good footage. Did you get me taken off on the drone?
No, you took off first, didn't you?
Yeah, I
asked everyone to stay in a group, but okay. I might have got some. I was just sitting there, waiting for everyone to go under it, and then I sort of followed you guys and went up.
Got two bikes in, and a massive plume of dust, and that was it.
So. Yeah, it's just a lot of dust. Yeah. It's going to spoil it a bit.
Yeah, it is fantastic. Like, 2 days after a rain,
Beautiful. We just need someone to go through with a water truck first.
There we go, there's an idea. That's it. Chuck a slab at the council or something.
Nice. Yeah, they've probably got water tracks for the trains. The train up there, it's got water everywhere.
We'll organise another ride during winter or something. I'll just run through like it. So how far have we got to go to Lanmore? We must have a bit over half or something over Lanmore, sure.
It'd be about half.
It's been years since I've been up this way. Last I was up this way, I was still going to school and playing football up this way.
Well, when I left you guys and came on the road trying to catch up, went through that town, Penna, P-E something. And it said, after that, it said a sign 100 k's to go.
So that was 30 k's ago. Oh, there you go. Spot on.
And then the railway track, and there's a tree. And it's like...
So where's these wombat holes? Still further up?
Out towards Lamaroo. A little bit further. Not far off though. The problem is though, it's all in slightly underground grass up here. You've got four wheel drive tracks, but there's grass in between, so just stick to the tracks and have a finger over the front anchor, because there's a couple of, they're not bad where you can just like flip the throttle and jump the rear over, jump the front end over and you won't have any issues, but there are a couple of ones that are slightly hidden that it won't be an issue. Well, I hope yours are working because I'm riding tailed.
Yeah, I could do that.
Oh, you can go first and find
them. I didn't mark them. My memory shot the crap these days.
Oh, you'll remember after you hit them.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's right. That's where it was.
Back there now. Yeah, wasn't it?
That's what I'm worrying about. That thing's like a freight train to bloody pull up.
Plows on through,
Sound down for all that.
Nah, there's nothing that'll throw you off a bike like that. Just to do that.
Take it easy.
Mm.
I think
when
you go through a gate, but there's no gate, it's just a single post on the side. That's when the pothole, the wombat
pothole. Yeah.
So you see there's a marker spot. Yeah.
How far did you go on your 650?
To Lamaroo.
To Lamaroo, but
I got a really late start.
So you would have got, I was going to say, you would have got home fairly late, yeah. Oh, it's all fresh in your memory. You should be out in front. Well, this bloke keeps cutting laps around you.
Yeah, right.
Cool. What was the time, sorry?
Really half past 10. 10:26. It's not that bad.
It would have been tough through a couple of those tighter points.
I'll try and get ahead, pick a spot so I can video you guys.
Go for it. We'll give you a 5 minute head start.
Last time I did that, because there was no dust, so I just kept going. I couldn't find a spot.
You're enjoying yourself too much, aren't you?
I wanted to try.
There's no good spot, so I'm just going to keep going.
And then when I did, I thought, they have to go through the bush. Thought that'd look cool, and they all just went straight ahead.
I wanted to plot the track on the Voyager Pro.
Yep.
But it's on the other bike, and went on fucking rock.
Oh, serious?
It's locked on the other bike. I don't know what's going on. I've taken the grub screw, the locking screw right out.
Yep. How long have you had it on there for? Been on there forever, I suppose.
No, 2 months.
Okay, so it's not as if it's like,
what's wrong with the bloody thing? She won't unlock it.
Well, it locks on, so it's a good thing, but...
Yeah, can't swap bikes.
All the connections and whatnot.
Yeah, I can do it that way. Yeah. But that's,
I was thinking connections in the RAM mount, but that's a lot of stuff in the RAM.
Yeah, I'm waiting for Trail Tech to get back to me. See if they've had an issue with it.
Yep.
Yeah, a bit of a bummer. I really wanted to try it out.
It's pretty hard to miss.
Yeah, hopefully it goes around the post. Lead that on the hook.
How bad is the dust back here?
Oh, it gets pretty bad. You've got to keep hanging back.
That's the thing. There's a couple of sandy points. But you were playing on through. If I start dropping back too far, I'm never going to catch up like that. Just bloody get into it.
That's the best way of seeing anyway. Stay get on. Into it.
At region.
You get up through the Keith National Park there.
Yep. I mean, you can't even keep speed through it. There's just bobs down.
I've heard it's shit out there now. They put iron droppers in everywhere.
Here are a few bad things.
Back then, there was no national parks sort of policed it. Nothing. It was sort of free for all. I'm talking back in 1990, 1991, 1992.
So before I was born, actually.
Oh, mate.
I'm making me sound old.
No, you're experienced.
Nah, you're always learning. You're always learning.
You never know at all.
That's what you say, always tell when the meat works. You're always learning.
Thank you.
Been a long time since I've changed the tyre. I'm going to need help.
Mate. Well, it's been a day of close calamities. I hit a roo just a couple of k's back.
Did you? Did you catch him, did you?
Oh, yeah, I fucking nailed him.
Shit, I seen him. I pointed. I didn't know how far behind you were.
I let you have plenty of room because I knew there was going to be a couple of washouts.
Yeah.
Fuck. Oh, fuck. You come in off the side, just punched my left leg into the engine. It was only about a 4 footer or something, so it wasn't huge.
What a cunt. I didn't
need. You want to put the bike up in the shade here, mate? I just here on the flat?
Yeah. I'm going to need something to stick under it. I felt it squirreling around for a while on the floor.
You know, she hasn't got that much power.
Maybe it's the track, and I thought, nah, it feels too skitterish.
Got a bit of glass in it, that might help a tiny bit.
But, nah, it feels a bit skitterish for fucking.
Well, hang on. Nah, it's just a bit of stone out there.
Christ! She's a tube job, hey.
What's that?
Fucking tire. Fucking tire!
Is this tubeless or a tube?
Tube.
Yeah.
Did you see him?
Yeah.
He's on the ground there. He's got a 4 footer. Old mate was had their camera set up. Two guns across in front of me.
Yep. Yeah, that's why I was amazed earlier when I was saying, oh, there's usually more roos out here. And I'll hit one.
Wrong one.
Because I've got tire irons on a tube and whatnot.
I've got everything in too.
Yeah. Because usually if you pack we're everything,
good.
You'll never need
yeah,
it.
Yeah, I'm good.
Nah, flat tire.
Fuck, man, what do you want to do that for?
I don't know.
The bloody prick jumped
I don't
me.
Want the practice,
I can tell you. Have you got flat?
Yeah, you got a flat.
Oh, my
so God. It all happened within about the space of, what, 4Ks?
Yeah, about from where the roo, I felt, yeah. Where it started swirling.
He saw it, but I was too far back to see him pointing at it.
He just came on the other side.
Just coming off the left-hand side there, when I was looking at the track, and whack.
Go down.
I was probably doing about 90 or something or other, and he probably hit me. I slowed down to about, must have been about 75.
Okay, but you didn't go down?
No, I kept it upright, and I didn't smash any plastics, which I'm bloody happy about. This is not my bike.
Yeah.
Because,
no one should get a punch of that, because I fucking picked it up.
And nailed a roo back there, Cam.
Sorry?
Nailed a roo back there.
Yeah, you did one.
Yeah, about a little 4 footer.
There's about three.
Yeah, there was a heap of them. No, I kept it upright since then.
No good using that fucking Borex thing. I forgot to bring the bracket.
Oh, it's shit.
A little bit of a scratch on your left fork, that's all.
Oh, he's there. Okay, I didn't even look at that. No. Yeah. You want to take her off of this, or do you want to try and... Actually, it might be easy.
Probably easy.
Oh, you got the Baja tool.
Yeah.
I can love that.
Never used it yet.
Really? Oh, you'll love it.
We're gonna have to find something to stick the bike on. Yeah,
This is one of the guys on the Venture Riders Forum made them. I'll grab one, try it out. Oh, no, actually. Facebook.
Somewhere where we can stick it. Stick it.
Heavy fucking man.
Can someone just hold it that side?
Thank you.
again. I'm going to need someone to hold the bike so they can go over.
Yeah, he's a bit worried that she may try and go over. We might have to just redo the footings and put something else the footings.
I've got no access through now either. If you want to, I'll have to change the tyre out the bottom.
If you want to bring her, lean her over towards you guys a bit, that's fine.
Just watch the engine in there too, that point that
we play. That's right for the time being. How's it starting? Is it starting to go down on that side?
No,
or
no,
it should be right.
Yep.
Either moving, oh, Jimbo, you can. Don't want to. You won't be able to touch that as well. Yeah. You want to grab the axle just so it doesn't drop on the sand. So you got that. Oh, you got a chain guide as well. All the elements are against us right now.
Yeah, it's so just the heat.
Is it a major one?
Who knows?